Tonight on Kitchen Nightmares.
What is going on? You can't run a restaurant like that.
We're stopping service.
For the first time ever, Chef Ramsay takes on a Mexican restaurant.
This is the burrito here. It looks like someone's been sick on my plate.
Where the food is being made for the masses.
What were they expecting?
2,000 for dinner.
But eaten by few. The owners.
Paddy, I'm disgusted. Yolanda, that's a joke.
And managers.
It's some prize.
Seem to be on a siesta.
Look at them.
And only wake up when they argue with each other.
Oh, my God. I don't even know what could make it worse at this point.
What do I do now? Where do I go, Vic?
I'm this far from giving up.
Could this be the one that leaves Chef Ramsay speechless?
I never thought it was going to be this bad.
Maybe I'm too late.
West Nyack, New York, 30 miles outside of New York City, an eclectic town that lies west of the Hudson River. West Nyack is home to Vic and Yolanda Flores, who previously owned another Mexican restaurant that failed. They wanted to try again, but didn't have the money, so they asked Yolanda's daughter, Patty, to use her credit and savings.
I'm 100% owner on paper, but my stepfather, Vic, controls everything.
All right.
He didn't listen to me, he didn't listen to my daughter, he does whatever he wants to do. We have to discuss the problems.
We'll discuss the problem, we go on and on.
I thought this was a big opportunity, but from day one, it turned out to be a disaster.
It's tough, I can't chew it.
Initially, we were busy, and then after a while, the numbers started dwindling.
Is it normally this quiet?
So I said, maybe we should make some changes. And he said, everything's fine.
I've been thinking of changing the menu, but my husband say people like it. But how many people?
We spend so much time just looking out the window, staring at each other. So how many tables are there?
Not you know.
Figuring what can we do to bring people in?
It's like the blind leading the blind.
He always thinks that he's right. He'll decorate the way he wants to.
It looks like Tijuana threw up in here. He has a stuffed chili pepper that he moves around named Manuel.
Make fun of this.
The most that bothers me is that my daughter has ruined her credit.
I have to go cover a bounced check or something.
She has problem in her marriage. I just feel very guilty that I put Patty in this position.
I never thought it was going to be this bad.
Well, I realized it was bad. We can't pay our bills.
I resent my mother. I think she put her husband before me, and it's hurtful.
I'm just hoping to God that Chef Ramsay will help us, and that Vic will listen to him. Otherwise, our personal lives are going to be changed drastically.
Right. There's the sign, but grill 303. What the is that? Maybe I'm too late. Grill, Fiesta Sunrise.
Oh, dear. How are you?
Very well indeed, thank you. Grill 303 or
not a Fiesta? Fiesta Sunrise.
Okay, good.
Fiesta Sunrise.
Nice to see you.
Nice to meet you.
I thought it was too late. I thought it was the new restaurant already.
Oh, well, we don't change the little logo in the front.
You haven't changed the logo on the front?
No.
And it's been like that for how long?
For a year and a half.
A year and a half?
Yeah.
Okay. Right. What's that?
This is a new favorite of margarita we have in here.
So it's complimentary?
Complimentary, exactly.
Wow.
Yeah.
So you don't have to pay for drinks, you just come up here and...
Well, you know, when the people, they're coming in, we try to be, you know, give us something to appetizer to start. Too strong. Ale? Tequila?
Right, let's put some warmth on my... Okay.
Yes.
Should we sit down?
Please.
Excellent.
Done.
So that's free. Right. Wow, look at the size of this place. So how many seats have you got there?
120.
120?
120, yes.
Wow. How many's booked for lunch?
Two tables.
Okay, what would you recommend?
The combination number one.
Number one combination.
One taco, you have one taco, one burrito, and one enchilada.
Okay. Yeah, I'll try one of the fajitas as well.
Okay.
I'm hoping that Chef Ramsay kicks Vicky's butt.
What is that on there? Looks like I've got a sticker on my menu. Just trying to peel it off, and it's bugging me. The art of Mexican cooking. What is that under there? The name of the... What name is that?
It was my another restaurant that I used to have. Fiesta Garibaldi.
Fiesta Garibaldi?
Yes.
So you brought the old menus from the old restaurant into the new restaurant and stuck some sellotape on there?
Exactly. Yes.
And is that restaurant still open?
No, we closed.
And you called it Fiesta Sunrise as opposed to Fiesta Garibaldi?
Correct, yes.
I'm really confused, Vic. Same chef?
Same chef.
Same ingredients?
Same ingredients.
You brought the ingredients from the old restaurant into this restaurant?
Well, you know, different. We buy in fresh, but
you bought
the same
fresh
same
ingredients?
Menu. Yes, correct.
Thank you. For that.
This is your combination, okay?
Lovely.
Combination. It's very hot plate, be careful.
This is the burrito here.
Yeah.
It's hard to see that. It looks like someone's been sick on my plate. Chicken's so dry. It tastes like it's been cooked weeks ago. The beef. Excuse me. It's impossible to swallow.
I can see he didn't like it.
Mm-hmm. Wow. How old is the rice? It looks like it's left over from Christmas.
They cooked this yesterday.
Yesterday? How do you know that?
I check in the kitchen.
Check again for me, will you please?
Thank you.
It looks older than me.
¿Qué tiene? No le gustó.
¿Cuándo hicieron el arroz y por qué hoy no hicieron nuevos y todas las?
It's dreadful. Absolutely dreadful.
How's it going?
He hated the rice.
Why?
It's old. How old is it?
They're disgusting.
Yeah.
Basically, they taste of.
I always feel very embarrassed. First of all, there was the menu, and the more important thing, there was the food.
That is gross.
Oh, now it's my fault.
No, I'm just asking you.
Oh, no. So you bought the glasses from Garibaldi as well.
We invested a lot of money into this. We should have known this a year and a half ago.
Yeah. Maybe that's the key when you come into Fiesta Sunrise. Stop off at the tequila bar, get drunk, and then enjoy the food.
You know, when you listen to me.
Hi,
hello.
How are you?
Very well, thank you. How are you both?
Good. I'm
nice.
Patty.
And your husband and wife?
I'm stepdaughter.
Okay, sorry, I thought you said you were partners. Excuse me.
We're all partners.
Okay,
yeah, great. Nice to meet you.
Likewise, and first name is?
Yolanda.
Yolanda, right.
I was the pina colada.
That was delicious. Sad, that is the only thing that I enjoyed. Let's go over to the bar and have a little chat, yes?
I'm hoping Chef Ramsay will convince Vic that change is good. You know, I think they're stuck in their ways. We should have stepped in a long time ago. Now it just seems like this is the end of our rope. Hopefully we can make some type of changes to save this business.
All three of you pay for the business?
No, these two.
You two pay for the business, and this man runs it?
He ruins it.
Ruins it, runs it, runs it.
Runs it or ruins it? Yeah, so far, ruined, yeah? Did you have anything to do with the old business?
I didn't.
No?
No.
I did.
You did. So that restaurant failed, and then you came to run this one for your wife and your stepdaughter?
Yeah.
But before you left, you grabbed the chicken, the menus, and the glasses?
No, just the menu.
Okay. I'm trying to get my head around this. If you all own it, and he's running it, why aren't you involved?
My opinion is, I think he just wanted us to finance him a restaurant. I put a lot out here. I put my credit, my home. I borrowed money from my father-in-law. It's not important to him. It's not important to him to make things right with me.
What does it take to break even? How much do we need to take a week to break even?
90,000.
A month.
A month, yeah.
A month, so 22 grand a week.
We do a third of that.
So you're losing $500,000 a year. What's the debt?
About 850.
850,000. And you've only been open for 18 months.
Right.
What in the f- have you been doing?
No, I'm the big guy in here. Everything is going wrong. They're picking at me.
I will see you later. Thank you, ladies.
See you later, chef.
Vic.
That's embarrassing. Right now, they're all blaming each other, and it's bloody obvious that Vic has run the place into the ground, but how can the women complain about that if they haven't put the time and effort in this place? So, personally, they're all to blame.
Coming up, Chef Ramsay uncovers the most disgusting...
Oh, my God.
...horrifying...
Look at the fat.
...and repulsive restaurant...
What is that?
...that he's ever seen.
Ladies and gentlemen, we're stopping service.
And later, tensions finally reach a boiling point.
I pay my bills. I pay your bills, too.
My bills.
Could this be the restaurant that just can't be saved?
I'm this far from giving up.
Coming up on Kitchen Nightmares.
This restaurant's run with dysfunctional management, and I'm dying to find out how the kitchen actually functions, because how is it possible for someone to cook food so bland as that? And tonight, I'm going to find out, but I'm not eating again, that's for sure.
Do you like some appetizer?
Quesadilla.
Okay.
Wow, look at the size of this kitchen. It's huge.
Ambrosia.
Ambrosia. Gordon. Okay. In there, what's that in there?
The turbo fridge.
Holy crap. Ugh.
Oh, when was the last time this was cleaned out?
Yesterday.
And what's this?
That's the rice.
The famous rice?
Yeah.
That's the fresh rice, is it? I got served the old, yeah? What's this one? Where's that one from?
Yesterday.
Which one's the fresh one?
I was disappointed a bit in the cooks. It seems like I see this place for the first time.
Hi, how are you?
Can I get the chicken enchiladas, please?
Okay.
When were these done?
Yesterday.
Yesterday? Oh, Vic, please. They weren't done yesterday. Okay. You can ask him his own language and ask him very, very quickly, when were these cooked?
Cuando cocinaron eso?
Bien.
Oh, so this one's for last week?
Of course they're from last week. They don't look like they're lunchtime, do they?
These chips taste like cardboard.
They're
tasteless. I have no taste whatsoever.
Okay. Oh, my God. Look at the fat. Look.
Why is there so much disgusting fat on there? What's wrong with those chips?
I think only one. You say that it's a little crispy.
So you take them from the table back into the drawer. Did you see that? They come back from the table and you put them back into the drawer.
Well, he said he didn't touch it. He touched one.
He said he touched one. But you're not supposed to.
We're like a bunch of children that are doing the wrong thing.
What are these? Vic.
Yes, Chef.
These were fresh chives. Sell by date, 5 months old.
Where do you find that?
I found them in the fridge. Smell them. Vic, look, let me just show you something. What is that? I'm getting nervous now. Talk to me. What is this?
That's the fish we're using.
That's the fish you're using? Oh, me. Smell that in there. Is this today's fish?
No, the fish, that was really scary because it was smelling bad already. I just couldn't believe it.
Where's Patty?
Yeah?
Have a look at this. Oh, my God. What? Look how crispy and curled up it is. Just touch that.
Oh, it's, like, solidified.
What's this here?
This is steak chop.
Why is it all wrapped up in tinfoil? Look at the colour of it. It's oxidised. And what's that in there?
It's pieces of pork.
That's pork. What have you done to it? Why is it all stuck in there with blood at the bottom of the tray? Why is that? How old is this stuff?
Yesterday.
Yesterday?
He said Friday.
Look at that. Oh, my God. When's all this from?
Friday. He took it out Friday.
Oh, everything's Friday.
Look, let me just show you something. Look how green and slimy it is. That's from Friday. Look. Look at that. That's from Friday. Look at my fingers. Friday. Look. Look. There you go. That's from Friday. How do you say this in Spanish? This is not healthy.
No muy saludable.
Thank you. What is going on in here? A hungry cat would walk away from that.
I was mortified. I felt embarrassed for letting this go on for so long.
While customers in the dining room continue to eat subpar food, Chef Ramsay's kitchen investigation intensifies.
What is going on here? What's that?
The burritos.
What's that one?
The chicken enchiladas.
Oh, how? Oh my God, what's that?
That was the ground beef.
Ground beef? Half of it's fat, you idiot. It's fatter than you.
I felt satisfied that finally somebody called him out on his.
Oh, what's that?
The bean.
Oh, how? It's like a cement mixer. Are you stupid? Who's controlling this?
I am, Chef.
You are. You are a walking disaster.
Now I'm feeling like stupid.
Lift it up. The fridge is full of it's disgusting. I wasn't here on Saturday, but what were they expecting? 10,000 customers for lunch? Paddy, I'm disgusted. Yolanda, that's a joke.
I understand. I don't want people to get sick, and I don't want them to spread the word that food is bad here.
You're overstaffed, underworked, food. I wouldn't trust you running a bar, let alone a restaurant. You must be out of your tiny mind.
I don't care for your restaurant.
I want to take that out there. I dare you. Take it out there. Go on. Give it to them. Yeah, there you go.
It's with me.
Look at me. Why wouldn't you take it out there?
That's embarrassing.
It's embarrassing. Why are you serving it? You don't care.
Why?
Why? Because you're serving that and trying to charge people money for that. That's why you don't care.
I care for this.
You don't care. No way. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm so sorry, but we're stopping service.
Shocked by disgrace.
What is going on here?
After disgrace.
How do you say this in Spanish? This is not healthy.
After disgrace.
I want to take that out there.
Chef Ramsay had seen enough and took matters into his own hands.
You don't care. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm so sorry, but we're stopping service. Everything you've had to drink, eat so far is all on the house. Sir? That thing in your hand, put it down. If you'd just seen where it's come from, like I have, you wouldn't be eating it. Very sorry. Close up. No pill anywhere.
I was like, what the hell are you doing? You can't do that to my customers.
By the way, there's your refried beans on the way out. Have a look at it.
Oh my God, it's garbage
pockets. I couldn't believe it, and seeing all these people walking out of the restaurant, it was like, this is the end.
I think Vic got a dose of reality. He walked around like he was untouchable. So I was relieved that finally somebody else told him that he was responsible for a lot of this.
While Vic supervises the cleanup, Chef Ramsay spends his time with a woman who is torn between her daughter and her husband.
What I'm really concerned about is what's happening to your daughter.
How did it start? Because something's blurring for me.
My credit was messed up. So we used party for credit.
Right,
too.
She was clean.
Clear, yeah.
You've destroyed your daughter's credit because now she has no choice. I mean,
yes.
You and her are in the my darling.
I know, sometimes I can't sleep at night.
Do you love Vic?
I do, but it's different now, you know. No, before you came here, I said, if this doesn't work, I don't think you and I could be together anymore.
Who's more important, your daughter or your husband?
My daughter. At this point, you know, I realize it's not really a choice.
Right now, the only way to show Patty how much you care is to get involved.
Yes.
To help turn this business around.
Oh, you tell me what to do.
Another marriage that is affected by Fiesta Sunrise's debt is Patty and Don's. Usually, Don drops her off to avoid running into Vic, but on this occasion, Patty asked him to come in and meet Chef Ramsay.
Good to see you.
Good to see you. I want to save the relationship with my husband because he's really angry at me for getting involved, and it just seems to be spiraling out of control.
Patty explained, I'm absolutely furious in terms of the way the kitchen was run, the way the place has been abused, and I can't believe a guy like Vic would try to do so much under your own eyes without even you knowing anything about it. Are you aware of what's been going on?
We fight all the time about it.
Yeah.
He saw it coming, and I said, no, he wouldn't do this, he wouldn't do that, and he said he's not who he appears to be.
No.
He's taking advantage of you and your mom.
You know, even mom admitted last night that you had a clean credit record.
Oh my goodness.
So that got abused.
That's in the cover.
That's the one thing I'm mad at. You know, money can always be made and repaid back.
Yep.
The credit, you just never paid the monthly payment on.
Do you think you can get more involved in terms of the support mechanism?
Oh, sure.
When I saw Dan, my reaction, it was like, oh, this is Patricia's husband. This has nothing to do with the business.
Hi, Chef.
Sit down. I'm trying to get to the bottom of it, Vic. I'm trying to understand the madness into how we've been operating. When you knew you were borrowing all that money from family, why weren't you being more honest about where the money was going?
Yeah, you know.
Well, it's not clear. Now it is. But when I asked him, are you going to give Patty any money? No, I don't think so. That really doesn't cut it.
I believe Don's trying to stand up for me. He feels that Vic walks all over me.
You're not going to give my wife any money? You're going to walk away with all the cash?
You have to go and something.
I paid your mortgage here, you jerk. 1 month, I paid $50,000.
Oh, you don't even have a job.
I don't have a job?
What are you doing?
Pal, I got a job.
Oh, please, you're hunting. You fishing. This is your job.
I have downtime. I do what I want. Oh, I pay my bills, God. Pal. I pay my bills. And in fact, I pay your bills, too.
My bills.
Relax.
While Patty and Don were discussing their financial situation...
Are you aware of what's been going on?
We fight all the time about it.
Yeah.
Vic joined the conversation.
Sit down.
Accusations were made.
You don't even have a job.
And Don and Vic were at war.
I don't have a job. I pay my bills. And in fact, I pay your bills too,
what
bitch.
Relax. Let's go. Can't say that. You can't start talking about that. You can't start telling that. You can't.
This ain't even half the.
I'm upset. My husband really wanted to help, and he's probably going to be mad at me for putting him in a situation like this also. So, in a way, I'm mad.
I'm here to help this place turn around. But to make this work, all three of you have to work as a team.
While the family cools off, Chef Ramsay heads to the kitchen to come up with a game plan to fix the restaurant's biggest problem. The food.
Oh my God. What in the is that? That is a joke. Victor. Right, ladies. I want us all to get involved in doing something together. Yeah? So I wanted a little fun element. You make a burrito, and the best one goes on the menu tonight. That's what I wanted to do. I couldn't do it because of these little here. Look at them.
Oh, my God. I'm so sick to my stomach. I want to throw up because I had coffee here earlier. I don't know if the roach went through my cup.
I didn't know about this problem either.
Two dishwashers, two prep cooks. Who's cleaning around here? Do they seriously put food on those plates?
Vic's here 7 days a week. I don't know how he didn't realize the problems in the kitchen.
Can't you see these?
I'm trying to move forward. I'm trying to get going, but every time I put my foot on the ladder, I get knocked back. Did you know this was like this?
I noticed, but...
You knew it?
Yeah.
We're gonna have to do something we cannot open. I need an exterminator here. How can I start even attempting to cook when the place is festered with cockroaches?
I didn't expect this. I don't think it could get worse. I don't even know what could make it worse at this point.
After Chef Ramsay's dirty discovery, he immediately called in an exterminator.
I have no idea things were that bad.
Bloody hell.
I'm pulling my hair out now. I'm sorry, but you're running the place.
Sorry.
Oh, you're so stupid.
Where do I go, Vic?
I feel embarrassed with Chef Ramsay. Yeah. I don't think that we can make it in this restaurant.
You can't run a restaurant like that.
You think I'm not? I'm embarrassed
You
now.
Should be embarrassed. I'm not putting one foot in that place until that place is clean. Yes?
You're right.
Now you start getting those guys cleaning, yes?
Yes, sir.
With some pride! Do you understand the word pride?
Yes.
It's not possible for someone to have his head so far on his me.
I was feeling so depressed because all the pressure that I have right now in the restaurant and everybody picking everything about me.
You know, he always thought he was right. Now he finally knows all of his mistakes.
I'm very sorry. I don't mean to hurt your feelings and I don't mean to hurt Danny's feelings. I'm very sorry.
After taking time to reassess the situation and allow the exterminator to finish, Chef Ramsay returns more determined than ever.
We are not giving up, do you understand? We cannot give up. Tonight we're going to open. The place has been cleaned, we're prepping up now, and in under 2 hours' time we'll be in a position to open up. And then we work it together.
Yes, Chef.
Yeah, are you going to listen?
Yes.
Due to last night's shutdown, Chef Ramsay was unable to experience a normal dinner service. Tonight, with the old food a thing of the past, he can finally observe the staff at work.
Tonight is all about fresh food. Everything we prepped this morning, we cooked tonight fresh, yes?
Yes, sir.
Fresh. What is it?
Fresh.
Louder.
Fresh.
You may be small, but you got a big pair of lungs. Fresh.
Fresh.
They speak English. They're just being clever by ignoring me, yes?
Yeah,
I know that.
What do you guys like to drink?
I'm gonna have the chicken fajitas.
And one beef enchilada.
Thank you.
With customers in the restaurant, Chef Ramsay is anxious to impress them with something Fiesta Sunrise has never had. Fresh food.
Bloody hell. Get me Yolanda, please. Hell. Yolanda, you cook at home, don't you?
Yes.
Yeah? What's wrong with this?
Overcooked.
Absolutely right. It's mush. We've got four chefs in the line. Not one of them can cook rice.
The cooks don't even know what they're doing. I realize how bad it is today.
I think you should start spending some time in here.
Yeah.
Can you cook rice now, Yolanda?
Yes, sir.
It's like a golf ball.
It's been a while, huh? A little hungry.
With the rice disaster, the kitchen is now backed up and the customers are getting restless.
Four chefs on the line.
Yep.
Doesn't seem to be happening fast. Yeah, can you speed up a little bit?
I'm starving. I just wish I had my food.
Excuse me, guys, we have four people over here. We have to start moving. What is these guys doing? They don't even know who's the leader over there.
We're finished with our meals and the rest of our table hasn't even received their meals.
Yeah, I
know. Service, please. Pass it over. What's those black bits coming from the...
From the top.
From the top of the broiler. When was the last time the broiler was cleaned?
The chefs that now is, they are crazy now. And
this, like, this place is half full. What are you gonna do when it's crowded and there's people waiting outside?
This is unbelievable. What the happening?
When was the broiler cleaned last, gentlemen? If he tells me Friday one more time, I'll boil him.
Every Sunday, they say.
Every Sunday, my ass.
This is out of control. I mean, you got food.
I'm full.
You got fishy food.
I've got four chefs that can't cook rice. Soot all over the food. What is going on?
Me.
You're supposed to put salt on the food, not soot.
It's a joke.
You're going? You're going to just leave?
They're not going to last it.
You can't employ these guys. One can't clean, one can't cook rice.
I never imagined how bad this restaurant was doing. I don't know what else could happen.
I cannot come to terms with what the f*** happening.
On the heels of another dreadful dinner service, Chef Ramsay knows he's running out of time to save this restaurant.
Hard day today. What we took tonight couldn't even afford to pay for the staff.
That's how it is every day.
Tonight is a perfect example that you're digging yourselves a bigger hole. We're tightening the noose around our necks. I've never been in this situation before. I'm now going to start taking drastic measures. We need help.
A lot of help.
A lot of help. I'm going back to New York City now, yeah? I have got to think of, an idea. Or we're screwed. I'm this far from giving up.
Next.
This place needs help.
Despite Chef Ramsay's many improvements.
I have an expert that's going to be here to help you. Now you have one beautiful restaurant.
Oh my God.
Look at it. Are you happy?
I'm very happy.
Will you tell that chubby face of yours?
Does this restaurant have what it takes to make it?
No more mistakes.
Or is Fiesta Sunrise just beyond repair?
Something's burning. What's going on, guys, please?
This is idiot-proof, and they still can't execute it.
Holy.
Chef Ramsay stayed up most of the night in New York City trying to think of something or someone to help salvage Fiesta Sunrise. He returned the next day, reinvigorated with a comprehensive plan.
Right, good morning.
Good morning.
Morning. Come round. After last night's dinner service, this place needs help.
Definitely.
I have an expert, okay, that I've taken care of, that's gonna be here to help you. She has the number one Mexican restaurant in Manhattan currently. She's from Mexico, and she seriously knows her Mexican cuisine. Oh. Say hello, please. Juliet. Ballesteros, come and say hello, please. This is Yolanda.
Hi.
Yeah, one of the owners.
So I got the call from Chef Ramsay. I got very excited. I will only do this for him.
Vic, they're ganging up on you now. One, two, three, four against one now. You're outnumbered, big boy. Woohoo!
I was pleasantly surprised when Chef Ramsay introduced Julieta because we really need the help.
With the kitchen in good hands,
next,
Chef Ramsay reveals the work his design team did to modernize the restaurant.
Oh my God!
Come through, come through, come through. Now, look at it. We got rid of the clutter. The ugly white banqueting chairs have gone. Look what you can see now when you look down through there.
It matches perfect.
Look at the tablecloths.
Oh my God, look! Oh, I love it. I'm in shock.
The shutters. Beautiful. All the crap gone off the ceiling. The walls have been done.
That glass
the walls
is gone.
Stunning.
Beautiful.
Now you have one beautiful Mexican restaurant.
Chef Ramsay is unbelievable. I can't believe that he worked all night to do all this.
I used to get dizzy walking in here. I used to turn my stomach, and now I feel calm. And it looks like a place you'd want to stay and hang out and spend some time.
Take a look at it.
I love my new decoration. I love my chairs. I love my new place.
Thank you very much.
I just want you to run it, yeah? With your wife, with your daughter, and run it as a team. That's all I want.
I promise to you, after this, no more mistakes. Thank you for coming. I appreciate it.
Having updated the look,
okay.
Chef Ramsay moves on to the most significant change in his master plan for saving the restaurant.
We've brought in an expert for the kitchen. We've revamped the dining room. And now the most important change that will be significant in turning this business around, and that's the menu. Do you like the new cover?
No.
No. Good, because that's what it's not going to be. There we go. Oh. That's what the menu is going to be. Simple, elegant, easy to read, easy to control, and maintain consistent standards. Have a quick look.
I'm very excited. I'm happy. Beautiful menu.
Read over the menu. I'm going to spend some time in the kitchen with Juliet, yes? OK, let's go, my darling.
In order to ensure a successful relaunch, Chef Julieta stays on top of everything and everyone in the kitchen.
The taquitos, just crispy enough to be like to have a crunch on your mouth, but don't overcook them.
I honestly never ever expected to be here tonight, relaunch night. What a week. The toughest so far. So now they have to pull it off. They may have the best Mexican chef from Manhattan, but it's up to them now. Everything's here, they've got to do it.
Let's see our meat. Oh, look, that's beautiful.
Now that you've got it, you run it. And I'll be watching the service. Tonight is crunch time. This restaurant has to have a successful service tonight. Okay, anything to say?
I hope we work together as a team, because I want something to be proud of, and I'm proud of my family, and I'm happy.
Everything is changed.
Good. Ready?
Ready.
We're opening in 5 minutes. Smile!
It's good. I'm excited.
That's as big as it gets.
You're like a sumo wrestler upside down. Smile!
With a contemporary new look and simplified menu, the success of Fiesta Sunrise now rests on the staff.
I'm excited, but I just want everything to go okay. So I hope they could pull this off.
You want an appetizer?
We're done. We're going to take the guacamole.
Mmm, that's good. It's for a kid, it's for a little girl, so don't put any peppers. They need somebody to be in charge. They need guidance, but they're willing to learn.
Medium rare. Y este que está delgadito, ponlo para el medium.
Chef, it says kind of cold. It went in.
Oh, come on. Julieta.
What happened?
They said it's cold.
Cold.
Yeah, because it's hanging around.
Okay, uno nuevo en 20 segundos, por favor.
Everything's set up. Everything's set up. So, you know, this is idiot-proof, and they still can't execute it. It's quite a worry. Come on, guys. Something's burning.
Yeah. They burned the nachos.
They burned the nachos? What's going on, guys, please? How the do we burn nachos? Holy holy what's this? Nachos flambé?
After a shaky start,
bloody hell.
The pressure is now on Vic to get the restaurant running smoothly.
This is excellent.
Is it good?
Very good.
Presentation is beautiful.
Dos carnes asadas, medium red, uno no arroz.
Good.
What do you think about the salsa?
I like this. It has a nice texture.
Thank you. Oh my God. I'm very excited. I'm very happy. For the first time, I see the people, they're smiling. They're talking good things about the restaurant, especially about the food.
It's a good piece of chicken.
I really like the quesadilla.
This is delicious.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
For the first time since it opened, Fiesta Sunrise is functioning properly. But they have one more hurdle to clear before the night can be considered a success.
I just had a phone call. The mayor of Nyack's coming.
The mayor?
Yeah, the mayor.
Oh.
Yeah, great.
Great.
So he's arriving for dinner tonight.
Wonderful.
Great.
Fantastic.
We had the honor of having our local mayor visit us.
Hi, how are you?
Fabulous.
Good.
I was a little nervous because I wanted him to enjoy our new food. I would recommend it because it's some exposure locally.
Hello, señores. Thank you for coming. Can I offer some appetizer?
We'll get one of each appetizer.
Okay.
Oh, yeah, that'd be good.
And put it all out here, right?
Thank you.
Vic, make sure that mayor's okay. Make sure he has a jolly time, yes?
What is this?
Taquitos, the appetizer.
Excellent. The
taquitos.
Yeah, that was delicious.
I'm coming back for those.
It was excellent food. We had a great evening tonight. I would absolutely come here again.
Thank you, Julieta.
You're welcome.
With dinner coming to a close and the mayor satisfied, Fiesta Sunrise finally saw a glimmer of hope.
Can you believe we made it to tonight?
No. Yeah.
Extraordinary.
I don't even know where to begin thanking Chef Ramsay. He came to me as a gift because I was really at the end of my rope, and he brought back happiness between all of us, and I can never thank him enough.
I honestly never, ever, ever thought we're gonna make it to tonight, you know that. Everybody had to wake up to get where we are now.
Yes, yeah. Chef.
And Vic, after all the mistakes you made and all the crap you're telling me, tonight, you were great! I was impressed with your performance tonight.
I'll be honest, I was nervous. The tables, all the customers, everybody giving a good compliments about the food.
Good!
I was, like, so happy.
For the first time since I arrived, I got to see your passion and your hunger to keep this place alive. That's what it's gonna take. And I'd like to say that tonight would not have been of any significant improvement without the help of Julieta.
Thank you, Julieta.
You're welcome. We're doing this to give this place a hope. We all need to work as a team and as a family.
Julieta, thank you personally.
Thank you.
Thank you very much indeed. Okay, go back a week when I arrived. I didn't know if I was in the right place. Signs with grill 303. I couldn't understand what the hell was going on here. I thought I'd arrived too late. Okay, come outside. Now, when we walk into the car park, yes, here's something that each and every one of your customers saw tonight. Yes, we did change it, so when they park in front of the restaurant, they know where they're eating. What's it called?
Fiesta Sunrise.
I can't hear you.
Fiesta Sunrise,
I still can't hear you.
Fiesta Sunrise, Chef.
Good. Make sure it stays up there.
We stay, the one that stayed over there.
Fiesta Sunrise. Got one more this way.
Oh, my God. Wow.
Oh, my God, Chef. You did it. You put the Fiesta Sunrise in front of the mall.
That's right, in front of the mall. Every day, 25,000 cars go past this restaurant. How could all those people drive by every day for 18 months and you not take advantage of that? Are you mad?
I'm happy. Oh, God.
Everybody that drove past here tonight saw that.
Gracias.
I'm not kissing you.
Yeah? I don't
okay,
kiss
good.
You.
Let's go. Okay.
This is my American dream. And I think it's going to be one of the best Mexican restaurants in town.
Keep it fresh.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.